Izina yangu niko John Kalonji Muteba.
My name is John Kalonji Muteba, not me, but him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Turizarika tuko seven mufami.
There are seven in their family, seven siblings.
Na papa alikuwa bishop.
And his dad was as well a bishop, a servant of God.
Tulikuwa kumkutanisha papa bishop, papa anasema alikuwa bishop, sisi tushakomea hapana.
So we got born when he was already a bishop, not when we grew and we saw him a bishop. No, we born when he was already a bishop.
She bote mufami.
All of us in the family.
Bote ni pakaba pastor.
All the siblings, they are pastors. Hallelujah.
Including na ba bajuku.
And even the grandchildren.
Na bote ni pakaba pastor.
Themselves, they are pastors. Hallelujah.
You know, so preaching yangu ya leo wewe ni unatufaka mipacha kwa siku ya leo.
That's the theme of his preaching today.
Wakati le papa alikufa,
so when their dad passed away,
pale mimi nilikwenda kwa Afrika, ndikuya huku mimi nakwenda kwa Afrika.
So he was already here when his dad passed away, then he had to go back home in Africa.
Ndikutanisha manjia yote wanafunga njia ya bantu.
So he came to realize that all the ways they were blocked because many people they were coming to the funeral.
Njuba papa ranzaka komba engari naye mtoto kidogo.
So himself, the dad, started to pray to believe in God when he was a little child.
I think mwebote munayua kanisa ya Redeemed Christian Church of God.
Maybe most of you know the church which is called, the denomination is Redeemed Church of God.
Njo kanisa ya kwanza ku Nigeria, ku Bantu.
That is the first church in how it is big in people in Nigeria.
Njo kanisa le papa aliletaka muzambi mujima. So, papa ndio alitoshaka ku Nigeria, anaileta muzambi.
So his dad was the representative of this church from Nigeria to Zambia.
Njo mana aliyuikana sana.
That's how he got famous.
Bari tueleza ma secret ngine mambo ya Mungu hata vile wanasema kama mambo ya Mungu hamuna secret memunikana ka secret.
And they taught us some secrets in the ways of God. Some people they think that everything is open in God's things. No, there are some secrets you have to know.
Kuko ma secret mwa inekana ka mu Bible umu ni paka bale wanashimama ku mazababu njo wanapasha kuyele ma secret.
There are some secrets which are in the Bible, but only those who are standing on the altar they will be able to disclose it.
Hallelujah!
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 I entitled my message today.
Ichigisho chanje chuyu munsi.
I entitled my message today.
Ichigisho chanje chuyu munsi.
Destiny helper.
Ah, inumbero. Umufasha agufasha gushika ku ntumbero ku muhamagaro wawe. Hallelujah.
Important of destiny helper in your life.
Agaciro cyawa kawa unda gufasha gushika ku muhamagaro wawe. Hallelujah.
In the journey of life,
mu rugendo rwawe,
you need someone to take you somewhere.
Urakeneye umuntu aguha gushika ku ntambwe kanaka. Hallelujah.
You need to meet certain people that they are going to present you in the corridor of power.
Biragusaba guhura na babantu bazogushitsa mu murombero w'imbaraga.
In our life,
mu buzima bwacu,
in the each and everyone in the world,
uri wese mu buzima,
you need someone.
Urakeneye umuntu
to fulfill your destiny in God. I can give you an example. Even Jesus Christ, our role model, he didn't fulfill his destiny by himself alone. He need John the Baptist to introduce him.
Yarakeneye Yohana umubatizi kugira ngo amwereke abantu.
He need John the Baptist to baptize him.
Yarakeneye Yohana umubatizi kugira ngo amwinjize mu mubatizo.
And then he needs the disciples to fulfill his promise.
Yarakeneye intumwa kugira ngo abarizo zijana ubutumwa hijya no hino. Hallelujah.
So you and me,
rero wewe nanje,
we need our destiny helper.
Turakeneye udufasha gushitsa
muhamagaro wacu. In the world,
kuko mwisi,
there is two kind of people. There is destiny helper and destiny destroyer. Destiny destroyer, they don't like anything about you. Or if you do something that is very good, but to him
it's
bad. They kill your faith in God. They say that you are praying, we don't see anything. That is destiny help. Destiny killer. But today I won't talk about destiny killer.
I'll talk
about destiny helper.
The
one who help you to reach your goals. The one who help you to reach your destiny. That is destiny helper.
Hallelujah.
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 Tell your neighbor that you need your destiny helper. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor that you need your destiny helper. In the journey of life, you need someone. Even if you are a politician, you need people to vote you. You can't be alone in this world. You need someone to help you to reach your destiny. So we are going to see in the Bible, one man suffered and God sent him a destiny helper. Hallelujah. We are going to read Acts chapter 3. We are going to read Acts chapter 3, verse 1 up to 10.
Gushika kumurongo w'icumi. Byakozwe n'intumwa gatatu.
We are going to go one by one up to 10.
Turagenda duherekereranya ijambo kuri indi gushika ku murongo wa 10.
Acts chapter 3.
Byakozwe n'intumwa gatatu.
Verse 1.
Kwera ku murongo wa mbere.
Up to 10.
Gushika kuri 10.
Let God help us to hear this word.
And
this word, let this word help us in our Christianity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Pastor David, you can read.
Umurongo wa mbere. Petero na Yohana bariko baraduga baja mu rusengero mu gihe cyo gusenga nicyo saha 9.
In English again, because I'm bad.
Okay. Katugende mu Cyongereza. Byakozwe n'intumwa gatatu.
Or maybe there is someone that you can read. Okay, you can read, my brother.
3.
Yeah. Okay, just read just one.
Okay. Now a man who was lame from birth.
First one. First just one? Go one again.
One day Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 p.m.
Amen. Just there. Peter and John.
Petero na Yohana
baranza kwenda kuomba Mungu.
Baragiye bagiye gusenga Imana.
Bible na sa pamoya together.
Bibili ivuga ngo turagiye ngo baragenda.
Kama unaangalia ile weather ile mo together.
Iyo usomye rya jambo ngo bari kumwe.
Iko banayandika 32 times mu book ya Acts.
Usamye muri iki gitabo cy'ibyakozwe n'intumwa iryo jambo ryanditswe inshuro 32 na 2.
Because kama tuko pamoya
nimba turi kumwe gutya
kintu kimwe kitafanishika
hari ikintu gikoreka
njye na saa Peter na John
kuko bavuze ngo Petero na Yohana
baranza kwenda pamoya together
barajana bari kumwe.
Bible na saa when two or three are gathered in my name
ijambo y'Imana ivuga ngo iyo babiri cyangwa batatu bakoranye mu izina ryanje
yesa Mungu iko pale
ngo Imana nayo ibana nabo. Haleluya.
Baranza kwenda pamoya
bari kumwe barajanya
ni kusema saa shiku ya dimanche
bisigure ngo ku munsi w'Imana nkuko
ni kusema ni shiku ya kusa tunakuya pamoya
bisigura ngo ni mwanya wo kuza
na kandi tunakuwa pamoya panapasha kwa miracle
kandi rero iyo turi kumwe nkuko duje umutima n'Imana ni nama haba ibitangaza n'utwumiza. Haleluya.
Na atafua bintu bya kusema nawe mwenyewe unaliona na mencho yako
kandi Imana izokora ibintu na uzibonera n'amaso yawe.
Okay, twendeni tu
reka tugende ku murongo wa kabiri
tu
murongo wa kabiri. So you'll be reading in English.
Hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello.
Microphone 4. Murongo wa kabiri avuga ngo hari umuntu yaremaye ibirenge uhereye kuva munda ya nyina. Yama aterurwa bakamushira ku irembo ry'urusengero ryitwa ryiza uko bukeye kugira ngo asege abinjira mu rusengero. Verse 2.
Yeah. Now a man who was lame from birth was being carried to the temple gates called Beautiful, where he was put every day to beg from those who we're going into the temple courts.
That's true. If you hear very careful,
umvirije neza,
Bible,
Bibiliya,
we don't know the name of that guy.
Uyu mugabo yararemaye ntabwo
batanga izina ryiwe. That guy was not important.
Rero bisigura ko uyu muntu atagaciro yarafite mu maso y'abana b'abantu.
And the Bible say was lame through. Alikuya kilema kuanzia pale alizarika.
Jambo jimani tumgie ngo yari kimuga ngo kuva avuka.
Na Biblia inatueleza banasema uyu mwanaume aba kumutaye jina yake ana na jina.
Biblia imuvuga ngo uyu nk'umuntu wese asanzwe nta zina
giye avuga. Akwenda important pa mencho ya bantu hapana.
Nta gaciro rafise mu maso y'abana b'abantu.
Problem ile wona pitamo
ikibazo ari karacamo
inezi kwenda kupachana jina.
Lishobora kuguhizina
angara uyu bwana banasema arizarika kuanzia mu ntumbo ya mama yake.
Ijambo y'Imana tubwiye ngo yari kimuga kuva mu nda ya nyina.
Na kama unaangalia mzuri
uravye neza
some problem
hari bibazo bimwe bimwe
atuipate hivi bula hapana
utabi bitaza gutya gutya gusa
ingine tunazarika nayo mafamii yetu
atari ivyo waronse waravutse oya wavutse ubifise bivuye aho uvuka mu ryango.
Bible. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, continue.
Okay,
soma tu yote umalize.
Soma guera ku murongo wa gatatu gushika kuri 10 uheze.
Twende bupeshi. Wakati haiko na sisi leo.
Verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him as he did John. Then Peter said, "Look at us." So the man gave them his attention.
Okay, just there. Mm-hmm. Just there.
Oh.
You know, he has certain expectation.
Yarafise icyo yiteze.
Oh my God. He was expecting to receive something. And now
teze kugira icyo aronka.
That expectation was bad expectation.
Ibyo byizero byari byizigiro bibi.
That's the reason why I came to tell you, you must change your expectation. Because he was expecting to receive something. Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
You know, if, just a minute. If you will look this scripture, they said that there was one man. Beautiful gate.
And he was seated on the beautiful gate.
You know,
so you start just to look in the spirits.
Problem.
So he is in the middle of an issue. But remember, he's seated in the gate, which is called beautiful gate. He's seated in a nice place.
What a contradiction. Try
just to follow, you will understand.
He's
seated at a beautiful place, at a beautiful gate.
It's not the partaker of that
beauty.
You can be surrounded with good house.
You can,
but you are not a partaker of that house. You can be surrounded with good cars, but you are not partaker of even one car. You see that contradiction?
Is
in the beautiful gate, but this life is totally miserable. Oh my God, continue.
Jesus.
Verse 5. So the man gave them his attention, expecting to get something from them.
Yeah.
Verse 6.
Wrong expectation. Continue.
Verse 6. Then Peter said, "Silver or gold I do not have. But what I do have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk."
Amen.
Just there. Hallelujah. You see, wrong expectation. As Christian of these days,
nkawa Kristo wo muri ibi bihe,
tunapenda kintu kupita mwenyewe ule kone tupatia.
Tushaka ikintu giciye mu wundi muntu ngo aduhe.
We need that God bless me. But we don't want the blesser. You want God to bless you, but you don't want God. I've come to tell you today, change your expectation. Like this man was in the beautiful gate. But thank God, he had certain expectation. But it was wrong expectation. Continue, my brother.
Verse 7. Taking him by the right hand, they helped him up, and instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong.
Amen. Just there. That's the reason why I say you need someone. Peter and John,
Petero na Yohana,
they were destined to this guy.
Bari abafasha bagenewe uwo muntu.
Kama tunarudia nyuma ya ile ya chapitre yenyewe bali tusomea.
Tusubiye nyuma gatoyi tukaja kugice cha kabiri imbere yaho.
Banamweleza sema silver,
batubwira ngo inza ngo ifeza
na gold
ninza hawo
atuna nayo.
Havya dufise.
Mekile tuko nakyo
ariki cyo dufise.
Mu jina la Yesu,
mu izina rya Yesu Kristo,
ushimame,
uhaguruke,
utembe,
ugende. Haleluya. Hey.
Mais comme on a ngara pala akutembe mana moya pala pala.
Ariko ni yashotse abaduka ngo agenda agende.
Mais mu verse 7 inasema,
but in verse 7 it says,
taking him by the right hand.
They
hold him by the hand.
You need someone
Ura kene yumo,
to
no?
hold you in your
hand.
You can't do by yourself. That's the reason why I said, as Christian of these days,
aba Kristo bo muri bibi
tushakupotesha ma destiny eupa betu njo atuna na discernment of spirit
twamaze gutakaza abantu bari batugenewe kudugira kudushitsa hano kuberako ataguhishurirwa tugifise. We lost our destiny helpers because we don't have the revelation to see who they are.
Ushishukie muntu njo akusema vile konaonekana.
Don't just despise somebody because of the appearance, of the mere appearance. You don't know what God has put in that person for
you.
God doesn't matter, doesn't want to know if that person is graduated from university. God is looking of what he has put inside of somebody.
Hallelujah.
You can see somebody just on the face.
But
you don't know what is mighty and powerful that God has bestowed in that person for you. Hallelujah.
How do you explain? David, a shepherd boy.
David just umungere.
He came king.
Akanaga kungere kiriginyuma inama.
Ushisule muntu muvi yako ndo nakuelezea.
Don't despise somebody in your life.
Ushisule muntu muvi yako.
Don't despise somebody in your
shepherd
life.
Shepherd anaanza kuchunga nyama mupori.
Shadrach.
Shepherd anaanza kuchunga David anaanza kuchunga nyama mupori.
David was just a shepherd in the bush.
Akorembia nyama miziki.
He was just playing a flute for but one day
when God, oh my God,
hallelujah, but when God wanted to change his life, he didn't ask anybody. Hallelujah. But he didn't say, can I bless David, yes or no? Don't just judge somebody by appearance. David was just in the bush.
How do you explain a king?
How can you explain a kama?
Oh my God.
Hallelujah. Can this open up your mind? Can this open up your mind? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Sarah mu Bible.
Read the Bible.
Sarah.
Sarah in the Bible.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Sarah.
People, they say Sarah didn't have birth.
Me Bible nasema,
but the Bible says,
mother of nation.
Nina wa mahanga menshi. Hallelujah. How can you explain to somebody? How can you explain to somebody this? The one which is despised.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. God, our God, is doing things which will be beyond our understanding.
Joseph. Alikuwa prime minister.
He was a prime minister.
How do you explain that kwa muntu mwenye unayue Mungu?
For somebody like him.
You need someone to take you somewhere.
Ukene yumono azogushitsa.
In the journey of life,
in the murugendo gw'ubuzima,
don't despise someone.
Nyakagira umuntu ukenge.
Take everyone with value. And you are going to see the hand of God in your life. Another example,
look this example I'm giving you.
Maria, a virgin girl.
Bikira Maria, umukobwa w'isugi.
Anakuya mama yetu ya Savior Jesus Christ. How do you explain that?
He became the mother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How can you explain
that?
You
are that? More than you look by yourself.
Wewe urenze uko wewe wibona uko wewe wiyizi.
Hallelujah.
You can just despise your own face.
But you are more than you look.
Ariko urenze uko usa uko wibona. Hallelujah.
You need your destiny helper in your life.
Urakeneye wa unda gufasha gushika ku
mbere. You need someone to take you somewhere.
Bira gusaba wa unda gushitsa ahantu. Hallelujah.
Mary muntu
Akuna muntu alimbalulaka Marie mu Biblia pa. Akuna muntu mwenye alimwekea Marie akiri mu Biblia pa.
Now, there is nobody who appointed Mary like that in the Bible.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Esther.
Look at even Esther.
Orphan girl.
Just an orphan girl. In full view, Mukob.
Anakuya queen.
Then she became the queen. Oh. Hallelujah. Our God, look at how you are seated here. The way you can see. The way you can see yourself, it's not at all. It has nothing to do with how God is looking at you. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Leo nyona mieleza Mungu atafua bintu binene.
Today, I'm telling you, God is going to do greater things.
Hallelujah.
I see the power of God in this place.
The
Hallelujah.
Presence of God is in this place.
Hallelujah.
If you believe today, you are going to descend your destiny helper. If you don't have one, we are going to pray. God is going to send you your destiny helper. The people
Hallelujah. They
are going to mention your name positively in the reign of power.
Kandi Imana izovuga izina ryawe mu mbaraga. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You know one thing that I'm going to tell you today? You must know that God is at work. God is working.
Imana iri kirakora. Hallelujah.
God is working.
Imana iri kukivi. Hallelujah.
You know, even if you look the life of Moses, we can go on and on and on and on.
Ushobora kwiyumvira byinshi 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 bigahamagarana.
Shebote tunavile Moses arizarika.
We all know how Moses got born.
Me njua riponesha batoto ya Israel.
But he's the one who redeemed the children of Israel.
Mungu angariake bunene.
God doesn't look at the big size. God doesn't look at the height. God minds about what he has put in your heart. That's what I'm dealing with today. The way you can be seen, your appearance, it's not the way you appear in the eyes of God. Hallelujah. God loves us, all of us. But it's now for us to love God. Nowadays, Christians, I know them very well. If you open up a prison, so many Christians, they will just be put in the jail. Themselves, they will just come and enter in the jail themselves. Nobody will be just pushing them. So, when they open the jail, don't get in. No. Because Satan is trapping us on a small things which is very hard to see. So these people which are holding this book, so watch out so that it won't be your own arrow to squeeze you. I really pity on many people. Somebody is just walking. But you look at that person. And you see, you can say, this is just an ambulance death. So you ask that person, do you pray? Do
yes,
you believe?
I'm a Christian.
Ego, domo Cristo.
But do you follow what the Bible say?
None. Uribanga urakurikira ivyo ijambo ry'Imana rivuga.
You know one thing that I love the disciples of Jesus Christ.
Ikintu nkundira abigishwa ba Kristo Yesu.
They ask Jesus.
Baba jije Yesu.
Rabbi,
mwami mwigisha.
Teach us how to pray.
Twigishe ingene twosenga. Hallelujah.
A prayerful man,
umusenzi,
is a powerful preacher.
No muvuga butumwa w'imbaraga. Hallelujah.
A powerful preacher,
umuvuga butumwa w'imbaraga.
Without prayers,
atagira masengesho,
it's not a preacher.
Uwo ntabwo ari umuvuga butumwa namba.
Hallelujah.
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 Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes, umami.
Oh God. Oh God. Okay. Everyone say, my Father, my Father.
Bose bavuga ngo data data.
I say everyone must say, my Father, my Father.
Twese twadukiye kuvuga ngo data data. Nusubiremo ati data.
Let's go together. Let's go together.
Reka tujane.
My Father, my Father.
Data data.
Release my destiny helper.
Rekura wa mufasha wanje anshita ku ntumbero.
My Father, my Father.
Data data.
Release my destiny helper.
Ndekurira wa wunda nshitsa ku ntumbero wange ndeye.
We need to have a destiny helper in our life.
Turakeneye umuntu adufasha gushika ku ntumbero Imana yatugene mu buzima bwacu.
Continue.
Reka ubandanye usome.
Verse 8. The Bible says he jumped to his feet and began to walk. Then he went with them into the temple courts, walking and jumping and praising God.
Amen.
Verse 9, when all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the same man who used to sit begging at the temple gates called Beautiful.
Amen.
And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, after this preaching,
inyuma y'ubu butumwa,
the place that you didn't enter in your life,
ahantu utigeze winjira mu buzima bwawe,
you are going to enter in the name of Jesus.
Urahinjira mu izina rya Yesu
Kristo. The things that you didn't catch by your hand,
bya bindi utakoresheje k'amaboko yawe,
you are going to catch it in the name of Jesus.
Ubicakire mu izina rya Yesu Kristo.
Because
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ is same,
kuko Yesu uko yari
yesterday,
ejo,
today,
uyumusi,
and forevermore.
Ni kwazo kwamaho ibiye bidashira. Hallelujah.
Today is today.
Uyumusi ni wo munsi.
God is doing something new in your life.
Imana ari kintu gishasha ari karakora.
God is doing something very nice in your life. If you can't see it by your eyes,
ushobora kutakibonesha amaso yawe,
but have the spiritual eyes to see it.
Ariko reka amaso yo mu mpemu yawe akibone. Hallelujah.
Because this man,
kuko uyu mugabo badusomeye hano,
was with wrong expectation.
Yari afise ibyizigiro bitari byo.
He was expecting to receive handout.
Yara irindiriye utwa ahabwa mu ntoke n'abahita.
He didn't know that today is my day.
Ariko ntiyarazi ko uyo munsi ariwo munsi Imana yagenye.
He was thinking that is the usual day that when he go and he go back.
Yarazi ngo ni nka muri ya minsi isanzwe aho yagenda akagaruka akagenda akagaruka afite utwa yahawe n'abana b'abantu.
When God wants to bless you,
Imana iyo yateguye kuguha umugisha,
he don't consult anyone.
Nta numwe igisha inama.
He don't consult anyone.
Nta numwe igisha inama.
He don't consult anyone.
Nta numwe igisha inama.
He don't consult anyone.
Nta numwe Imana igisha inama.
He consults on the word of God. If you have word of God in you, and God is going to consult you.
Hallelujah.
You know, like last week when I was preaching, I said, if one soul, when one soul come to God, and in the heaven there is joy, what about if
mbega none nigute nimba
unarudisha bantu bengine nyuma pakichwa yako we,
if yourself you are putting people they backslide
unasa
on your
kafanishika
head
kintu kani muvi yako.
What will be your benefit in your life? You are making people to backslide, to fall.
Biblia nasema kama mtu mmoja anakwenda kwa Mungu ni furaha kumbingu.
The Bible says if only one person is going into heaven, it's a joy into heaven.
Unalumiza mtu mmoja.
So you are making one person to backslide.
Anaanguka natoka mkanisa.
And that person is going out from the church.
Uona continue lako kuparafua binti yako mkanisa.
And you continue as everything is normal in the church.
Unaba makala ya moto.
And you are putting your hot coals in your head. You are just walking like normal. That person who is backsliding and is going through trouble out of the after church, it's not his problem.
Problem ni ya wolo rimtoshisha mkanisa.
It's you who made him or her to backslide.
Inapaswa mnakuwa sensitive kabisa bintu bya Mungu.
We have to be very sensitive in God's matters.
Inapaswa kubeba bantu bote namna moya.
We have to take all the people the same.
Hata mtoto kidogo,
even a little toddler.
Umpache heshima.
Respect even a toddler.
Yesu mwenyewe mbele anasema.
Even Jesus himself
anasema
said,
mwache batoto kidogo bakuye kumi.
Let little children come in closer to me. So who are you for you to block children to go to Jesus? There are some other things we are not blessed with. They are just like small, small things. But they are making many to backslide. We have to awaken. We have to be awakened in God's matters. And we have to feel inside ourselves. Because the Bible had spoken openly in everything. The Bible is saying, whatever you want other people to do to you, don't do a wrong another the other way around to others.
No.
Do the good thing that you want other people to do to you. Do it to other people. And you will see blessings from God. You will see the goodness of God. And you will see the greatness of God. It's not when we are all gathering like this on Sundays, we are coming at church, we become all Christians. No. It doesn't mean that if you can stand and preach, it makes you to be a children of God. No. If you are standing here, you sing, it doesn't mean that you become a children of God. No.
Kama kuya mtoto wa Mungu,
to become a children of God,
ni kuchunga bile Mungu anetuelezea,
it is to fulfill what God has spoken about.
Mungu
here.
Njo baba yetu.
God is our dad, is our father.
Njo anetueleza bia kwezi kufanya.
There is something that we cannot do.
Njo anetueleza kia kwezi fanya.
There is something that we cannot do. So if you are trying just to go other way around, and you think you have the Holy Spirit, so days are going.
For example, na 50 years.
And you were 50 years.
Unakuwa 50 years one day.
And you are 50 years one day after one day.
Siku ya kufuata unakuwa 50 years 2 days.
And the second day you are 50 years and 2 days.
Ukalamuke masiku unakwenda kumbela irudie nyuma pana.
These days are gone. They are not coming back. They are not rewinding. Be wise and open up your eyes.
Kule tunatoka njoo mbali.
Where you are coming from is far. Where you are going is very closer.
Try upime kuya karibu na Mungu wako.
Try to come back to your God.
Na umulombe Mungu wako.
And pray your God.
Tuone kama Master kubariki.
And you will see God will bless you.
Na Mungu mwenyewe anatuakiza anasema Mungu anatuelezea asema.
And God told us,
muombe,
pray,
kiokiote,
anything,
kile unataka,
whatever you want,
takufanizie.
And I will fulfill it.
Sasa atupokee ni njia ya nini?
So why don't we receive?
Ndio kusema tufuate ma nani ya Mungu hapa.
That means we lack to fulfill what the Bible tells us to do.
Kulikuwa mtu mwingine mu Biblia?
There is somebody else in the Bible.
No, hapana mu Biblia. Mimi napeleka kulikuwa tu mtu mwingine naye hapa pa dunia.
Not in the Bible but just in the word, there was somebody in the word.
Aliua naye ile masauti ya Mumatie.
And he was according to this what is quoted in Matthew chapter 19.
Nasema omba kiokiote kitafanisika katika jina la Yesu.
And it was as it is saying, ask and you will be given in the name of Jesus Christ.
Kulikuwa mlima moya pa nyumba yake.
So there was a hill and just in the neighborhood.
Kama yuwe inatoka,
whenever there was the sun was coming,
iranzo mushibiria kufika pa nyumba yake.
So the sun, whenever the sun was setting, it was the hill was blocking the ray of the sun to come to his house.
Akakwenda maandiko ya Biblia.
So he went in the book.
Anasoma mu Matthew.
So he read in Matthew.
Asema utatosha mulima itanguka mumai.
You will remove all the mountains and tell them, go throw yourself in the water.
Wakati anaomba usiku,
so when he was praying in the night,
anafunga marido,
he closed, he shuttered all the curtains,
analala,
and he slept.
Anarudia asubuhi,
and he came in the morning,
anafungula,
he opens the curtains.
Asema tapale mlianza kumba miliwa sahi tenda pana.
So he was saying this will not be removed.
Aranza kuridute mwenye, anayua maandiko,
he knows the scriptures.
Me ana imani.
But he doubts, he doesn't have the faith.
Asema tapale mlianza kuomba,
and saying from the time I started to pray,
miri yua sema aita kuenda.
From the time, even though I started to pray, I knew in my heart that this mountain will not be removed.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
God is going to do something new in your life today.
Imana hari cyo yiteguye gukora gishasha.
Just believe in the name of Jesus.
Ndakwinginga gusa ngo wize.
There is no other name on earth or in heaven.
Narindi zina kwisi no mwijuru.
It's only the name of Jesus.
Ni zina rya Yesu Kristo.
If you believe in God, if you are a child of God, you are going to receive something that you are
urahabwa ikintu.
Kiro ranzo tafutaka miaka ya kumukongo wala kumbele huko.
Many things you have been looking for back in the days and years.
Today,
Uyumus,
if you have faith,
niwizera,
if you have faith,
niwizera,
like that man,
uyu mugabo twasomewe,
he had the wrong expectation.
Uyu yari afise ibyizigiro bitari byo.
Change your expectation.
Hindura.
Change your expectation. You are going to receive something that you want in your life. And God is ready to bless you. Change your expectation. You are more than you look by yourself. You are not looking the way that you are looking. But in the realm of the spirit, you are too high. You are too high. You are too high.
Hallelujah.
Try to put by yourself, try to put yourself higher. By the faith. I don't want to say anything.
nabindi nongerako.
You know, like last, it was when? On Friday.
Hari kuwaga tano heze.
When I finished work,
ahejeje akazi,
I was going home.
Aragodoka aja muhira.
I received phone call.
Baramuhamagara kuri telefone.
From my son, two sons, they are in Saskatoon.
Ari afisa abahungu babiri bari Saskatoon, umwe muri bo aramuhamagara.
Daddy, we are very sick.
Ambwira bati mubyeyi turagwaye cyane.
Of what?
Ati mugwaye iki?
We don't know.
Ntitubizi.
We don't feel anything, but we are so, we don't have any power.
Twumva mu ntege mu bikonjo atantege.
I said, no, I need to travel to Saskatoon. It was almost 10 p.m.
Aribwira ati ntegerezwa kugenda nje kubaraba aho bari aho Saskatoon hari sayine z'ijoro.
And I asked my last son,
acabaza umuhungu we muto,
because I have my last son is almost 24 years. I think so.
Umwana we muto muherezi afise hafi imyaka 24.
I'll tell you that, you know, the time that we are growing,
iyo turiko turakura,
because our father,
kuko data mwijuru,
akupende tutoke pamencho ya Mungu hapana.
Se wabo ntiyashaka ko bava mu bwiza bw'Imana.
Arisema munapasha ko wapale tunanisha tu 19 ans.
But when they were 19 years old,
asema utaoa unapasha paka kuoa.
So their dad was telling to them, you have to get married. Did you hear you guys?
Tunakatara tunakimbiririo kwa sapana unapasha paka kuoa.
So they were trying to run away, but he was just catching them.
Asema mishipende mnyanabishe kazi ya Mungu hapana.
He was saying, I don't want you guys to mess up my ministry.
Na shebote kwanza kumkubwa wangu wa kwanza.
So all of them, their siblings, even the firstborn.
Aliowaka na eko na 19 years, I think 6 months.
He got married, he was 19 years and 6 months.
Unayashe banaume mkichwa, banamuke banakana na kirimwa ya yulu sana.
So you know, women, they have higher understanding and intelligence.
Meshe banaume 19 years ile, mkichwa muko mai.
But for us, man or boys, in our mind at 19 years, it's just only fog.
Pale wanaitowe, shikuye na kia kwezi fanya, shikuye ki, asema mishipende kazi ya Mungu ikufwe njui yenu mwe hapa.
And their dad was saying, I don't want the ministry of God, where I'm serving God, to be messed up because of you.
Njo mana batoto yonka mina shimama nabu, kila mtu wote anakatalaka saina batoto yonka, njua kusaini bakubwa bote. Bengine beko balefu na kunipita na mimi mwenyewe.
That's why even his children, whenever he's standing with them, nobody will accept that they are his children because they are grown and they are almost the same. Did you understand, Solomon? And that's why, because they got married when they were still young.
Hallelujah.
Because they didn't have time to go panya road.
And when
you start just to have mind opening up, you know that you have some responsibilities already in your house, in your home. Somebody who is saying you have to come home with something to eat.
Sasa pale wananyeleza papa hakuna namna atushike mzuri me ukuye tu.
They said we don't feel nice, but we need you to come.
Mbele pale tulikuwa kukaji mina wazani ndieleza hata na Grace mishweka ndieleza Grace mirelezea Grace mina kumbuka mina mwende sema sele wangu ashike mzuri hapana.
And he said, he told to Grace, her co-worker, saying, you know, my son Sele is not feeling well.
Me miru wa desa ni malari paka vile.
And he was saying maybe it's sickness. And he asked to his son, where did you go just around to visit anywhere? And he said, I didn't go anywhere because I'm studying just online. And he said he decided, I'm not going to Saskatoon,
no.
If I go into Saskatoon, I won't be able to come to be ready here at church on Sunday. The God who said I will have to go to preach on Sunday.
Your hand is not too short.
Then I told to all my children, sit together. Then I prayed to them through phone. Today in the morning, he sent a message saying, Dad, we are feeling very well. Hallelujah.
Hey.
Don't come. On Saturday, we are the ones who will be visiting you in Calgary. Hallelujah.
You know, when you believe God, everything is possible. You know, Satan is very clever in our life. Maybe service of today is just for one person. And Satan knows that.
Kandi Satan arabizi.
He want to take me out.
Niho yashaka ngo ansamaze antware mu bindi.
But today,
ariko uyu munsi,
God,
Iman,
ule tunekaria pa mwena mie.
Wa undi yatumye wewe nanje twicara ngaha.
Atafanya miracle kwa siku ya leo.
Arakore gitangaza kuri uyu munsi.